Selman, owner of Evolution Trainers, and I wanted to talk to you today a little bit about barefoot training. It has become a huge trend these days that people are switching from traditional running shoes to barefoot shoes or five-fingered shoes, and the concept with those shoes are fantastic. Our feet are made to really absorb shock and be able to give more push off the ground than what traditional running shoes have allowed us to do. The problem is people are throwing their running shoes away, going right into barefoot shoes, and that is a recipe for disaster. Because since you've been using traditional running shoes, your feet have gotten used to that, and they're weaker than they would normally need to be in order to use the barefoot shoes. So it is really important to do a very gradual progression so that you don't get injured using your new barefoot shoes. So what I would recommend when you first get your barefoot shoes is start only wearing them walking around the house at first. And if you do strength training in the gym, you could wear them during those settings, but do not run in them for, I would say, at least a month of starting to wear them just walking and around in your training. Then when you start to wear them while you're running, you want to only wear them for very short periods of time. You could do running and walking progressions where you run for a minute or so and then walk to give yourself a break. And if you start doing continual running, you want to start with maybe just 10 minutes at a time and really take it slow, because there have been a lot of research now that people jumping right into barefoot shoes are ending up with injuries. And I know that's the exact reason you got those shoes, is to prevent